My name's Dr. Phil Porter. I'm a reader in geoscience and geoscience education at the University of Hertfordshire. So I look at shrinking glaciers in the high Arctic, in Iceland, in the European Alps and the Himalayas. You can think of Arctic ice, particularly Arctic sea ice, as a giant white umbrella that reflects sunlight back into space, back into the atmosphere. And so that keeps us relatively cool. In the Northern Hemisphere, that has global implications, though, as we reduce that amount of white cover. That leads to heating of those darker ocean and land surfaces, and that can cause changes in weather patterns, changes in ocean currents that ultimately affect us all. One of my main research interests is glacier hydrology, and that's how water moves within, beneath, and from glaciers. One of the things we're really keen to do is to predict how much meltwater is going to be produced in response to warming and in response to changes in precipitation, snowfall and rainfall, because that impacts on sea level, for example. But also, if we go to the Himalayas, we've got approximately a fifth of the world's population, directly or indirectly, dependent on snow and ice melt for their water. Being able to predict how those water supplies are going to change in the future is really, really important. So what we're involved in is trying to look inside the glacier and understand how the network of tunnels and pipes act to store and transmit water and how that changes as those glaciers shrink and as levels of melt increase. The work we do and the locations we visit is really useful in terms of trying to educate people about how glaciers work and how important they are to us all. You know, very few people know anything about glaciers. Very few people have actually seen one in real life, and yet they're pivotal to many aspects of the healthy functioning of our planet and for our continued healthy existence. 30 years ago, there was a lot of people who thought, well, it's not happening. It's just not happening. You know, we don't believe this is happening. I don't believe that humans can impact the global climate. I think it's then moved from not believing it's happening to, you know, okay, it's happening, but I don't think humans are the cause. And now I think we've progressively moved into a situation where it's like, yeah, it's definitely happening. Humans are the cause, and now we've got to do something about it.